Culture Summit lays out the thoughts of various stakeholders and initiatives in a participative dialogue on how Digital India would pan out to show a solid impact on the inclusive growth from 2021-25. The discussions through the day are going to lead us onto this path. A few such initiatives that have already left a mark on this journey are with us this morning, and some of the independent experts who have helped us identify such successes are also with us. Before we start the announcement for the Scotch Order of Merit 2021 today, a couple of announcements on the live voting process. Since this is the last leg of the award process, you have a last chance to garner additional votes and marks, which is 10 to 12 expert voting polls would be open randomly at intervals through the day. Therefore, all delegates vote for their favorite projects 10 to 14 times. Kindly do look for it. Each poll will be open for 5 minutes to allow the maximum number of delegates to participate and vote in this. And it's advisable for all the delegates to be attentive to the polls. Welcome to the Scotch Order of Merit semi-final announcements today. We are joined by this morning by our independent panel of experts whom you have had an opportunity to interact with. Let me have the pleasure of introducing Dr. Shefali Das. She's distinguished fellow with Scotch Development Foundation and former Director General with National Informatics Center. Mr. Madan Mohan is Senior Fellow, Scotch Development Foundation, and is former CGM NABARD and CEO of NABARD Consulting. We are also joined by Mr. G.B. Panda, Senior Fellow, Scotch Development Foundation, and former Senior Advisor with Niti Aayog. We will have an opportunity to get their reflections once we complete the announcement of the Scotch Order of Merit. Let me invite Dr. S.C. Bhattacharya, Scientist G and Associate Director from DRDO, a faster, reliable, digital, non-destructive technology for strategic systems. So this Order of Merit is being received by Advanced Center for Energetic Materials, DRDO. Yes, would you like to say a few words?
This is S.C. Bhattacharya from SEM DRDO. I am very thankful to Scotch Awards to recognize our work on a faster, reliable, digital, non-destructive technique for strategic systems. Actually, this is a novel technique for non-destructive evaluation of rocket motors, and which has been already introduced in strategic systems in DRDO. So, and this is the first time in India and in DRDO also. So it is very satisfying to note that the distinguished jury has already taken note of it, and they have also recognized this one. Thank you very much, Scotch.
Congratulations to you. I now invite Mr. Rajiv Arora, Additional Chief Secretary, Ayushman Bharat Haryana Health Protection Authority, for Ayushman Bharat Haryana Health Protection Mission. Mr. Ashok Bandopadhyay, Associate Director from CDAC Kolkata, for Karkat Nirnay Yantra, an infrared imaging based breast cancer screening system.
Thank you, sir, for providing this opportunity. Myself, Ashok Bandopadhyay, Associate Director, CDAC Kolkata, on behalf of my team and CDAC Kolkata Center, thank you very much, the Scotch Award Committee and the President of Scotch in particular, for giving this opportunity to select our product. This is infrared-based imaging based breast cancer screening system. Essentially, it's a non-invasive and no touch, no pain mechanism for detecting and screening breast cancers. As we all know, Indian scenario, this particular disease has really spread like anything in the northeastern part of the country mostly. So we have been entrusted this activity with the help of the Ministry of Information Technology, which is our parent body. We are very much thankful to our ministry as well. And I hope our product will help to the common people, particularly the women sector, to detect their disease in the early stage. So thank you very much. Thank you once again. We will definitely continue to contribute in this way with your patronage. Thank you, sir.
Congratulations to you, Mr. Bandyopadhyay. I now invite Dr. N. Bhattacharya, Senior Director and Center Head from CEDAC Kolkata, Development of Autonomous Multipurpose Agricultural Robotic Platform.
Good morning, sir. On behalf of Dr. Bhattacharya, myself, Dr. Hina Roy from CEDAC Kolkata, Joint Director, and I am really privileged and thankful to Scotch Award Committee. And this is a project that is being sponsored by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Government of India. Also, although this is a very 1 year short term project, but we are able to deliver the entire production or the prototype for the deployment in the our Indian agricultural scenario. Basically, this is helpful for the small and medium scale farmers, and that will be able to do the entire operation of the paddy farming, starting from the sowing of seeds to harvesting through the autonomous multipurpose robotic platform, and that no need of human intervention during the operation of this process, because we understand nowadays there is a very much the degradation of the manpower, shortage of labor in Indian agricultural scenario. So that's all about from my side. Thank you very much once again.
Beautiful project, and congratulations to you. Once again, Mr. Ashok Bandyopadhyay, Associate
Director. My name is Dr. Hina Roy.
We acknowledge it, ma'am. Thank you. Mr. Ashok Bandyopadhyay, Associate Director for Online Signature Verification System.
Thank you, sir. Once again, I am privileged to be present here on behalf of my team and CEDAC Kolkata. Pertinent activity of online signature verification system. This has been installed in one of the university strong room for access control unit, and this can be utilized for banking sector as well. This is a very advanced technology where online signature is being captured and based on which some person authentication is being done. And this is one of our very important project of our center. I am once again thankful to our center head for providing this opportunity to work on this particular aspect and my team. And thank you, the Scotch Award Committee, for awarding this.
Congratulations. Mr. M. Theodore, Director, Defense Bioengineering and Electromedical Laboratory, DEBEL, Real-Time Remote Health Monitoring and Diagnostic System for Armed Forces.
Sir, could you able to hear me? This is Mohan from the. Sir, could you able to hear us?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir. Good morning to all the people who are present here, dignitaries. And this is Mohan Bell. I am a joint director on behalf of the director Devil, Panimani Theodore. I am present with my team. And first of all, thanks. I would like to thank and convey my deep thankfulness to gratitude to all the juries and the entire Scotch team, as well as for the people who worked for us. This is a project and very important, very challenging of a real-time health monitoring of the soldiers of the armed forces of Army, Navy, Air Force, who are really away and being posted in the real time in the war scenario, as well as the forward areas. Monitoring the health profile is a very important scenario, and it's not like in a controlled condition like in hospital. So we have been able to make in a military grade equipments as well as the software customized for Army and Navy, and also it's being deployed and getting integrated into all the ships and submarines of Indian Navy by changing the game scenario of the digital transformation into for an entire change of the naval medical management system and also the Army for Army. And this is a very thanks to our team also present here, who had made a valuable contributions last one decade of recent development of the hardware, software of military, as well as the patient safety certifications, and very thorough deployment in the ships who are away from in the Bay of Bengal and all the oceans. And now it's being accepted by the Navy and is being getting integrated into the entire naval medical management system. Thank you for once again to everyone, sir. Thanks so far.
Congratulations to you and the entire team.
Thank you.
I now invite Mr. Arun Kumar, Commissioner of Agriculture for Rayatu Bharosa Kendralu from Department of Agriculture, Government of Andhra Pradesh.
Good morning, sir. This is Arun Kumar. Am I audible, sir?
Yes.
Namaste, sir, for the Scotch Committee and also all the dignitaries. Let me express my gratitude and gratefulness to the Scotch Committee for considering this unique project. You know, sir, that farmer is the backbone of the country, and so is with the Andhra Pradesh state. And the state has come up with this initiative of establishing the farmer facilitation centers, which roughly translates into Raitu Bharosa Kendras at all the villages. The scale is such that we have 10,600 such farmer facilitation centers across nook and corner of the state, which are offering services from making available the quality inputs and quality extension service. And we are even going further to offer him the minimum support price for the farmer. So it is like farmer need not look to any other agency, but to the center at the village level, which is at his beck and call for responding to his genuine requests and genuine demands. And this recognition we consider as a recognition of the Indian farmer, the kind of effort he puts in and the kind of effort he has put in to bring the country to a state of nutritional security. And from a day where we used to import food, now from a day to where we are exporting food. So this is a recognition of the Indian farmer and Andhra Pradesh farmer. We once again thank profusely to the Scotch Committee for considering this initiative, sir. Thank you very much.
Congratulations to you. I now invite Dr. Geeta M., Secretary and Agriculture Production Commissioner, Government of Chhattisgarh, Department of Agriculture, Development and Farmer Welfare and Biotechnology for Project Gaudhan Nyay Yojana. Mr. Ashutosh Garg, Director IT, Government of Andhra Pradesh for IT applications and solutions developed by DOIT-HP during COVID.
Thank you, sir. I am Rajiv Sharma,
Government of Himachal Pradesh.
Department of IT. First of all, thanks. Thank you very much, Scotch Group, for recognizing our initiative, which we took during COVID-19 pandemic. This application helped health department to monitor COVID-19 patients across the state, as well as to monitor their inventory in various health institutions during this pandemic period. So thank you very much for recognizing our event initiative.
Congratulations. Mr. Ashutosh Garg, from Government of Himachal Pradesh for private access point name to access departmental application over secure intranet from anywhere.
So thank you once again, sir, for recognizing our this initiative too. Even this tool helped us a lot during COVID-19 lockdown, where we have to access our internal applications while sitting at home. So this dongle proved to be a very useful tool. So normally we used to access internet using our telecom service provider dongles, but we specifically configured, got this configured in such a way that the moment a person connects to using this dongle, they immediately come to our intranet. Instead of going to internet, they directly come to our intranet domain, and people were able to access their applications online. So excellent. Thank you, sir, once again.
Wonderful. Congratulations once again. Deputy Director, Mr. Hari Shankar Nuwad from Department of Women and Child Development, Baran, Raksha Kavach. Ms. Harshika Singh, Collector and District Magistrate from District Administration Mandla, for Nirakshakta Se Azadi Kam Project Gyanalaya. Mr. Vijay Amruta Kulange, Collector and District Magistrate from District Administration Ganjam, Mo Upkari Bagicha. Mr. Vijay Amruta Kulange once again for Project Deshi, which is development and empowerment of SHGs through hen farming. Mr. Rohit Singh, Collector and District Magistrate from Jhabua, Mission Chiranjeevi.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Thank you so much, sir. It's very encouraging to see Mission Chiranjeevi among semi-finalists and in Scotch Order of Merit. It will provide fillip to our initiative towards providing safe motherhood and childhood to the population of a tribe-dominated district and a challenging district like Jhabua. Generally, such initiatives go unnoticed and unrecognized. So such recognition will bring the focus back to tribal health and development, and will also motivate the team to put in total effort. My thanks and gratitude towards the team Scotch, jury, and esteemed panelists. Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Mr. Pankaj Rai, Deputy Commissioner from District Administration Lahore and Spiti for Winter Festival.
Dr. Gurucharan, this is Mohan. Can I speak for a second, sir?
Sir, where are you from? Please identify yourself.
Sir, I am Mohan from Infrastructure Equipment Skill Council.
We will come to you.
I just wanted to, sorry to bother you. I just wanted to re-log in. There seems to be some problem with my camera. I'll re-log in, sir. That's just to tell you that.
All right, no problem.
Yeah, thanks, you. Thanks a lot, sir.
May I continue?
Yeah, Mr. Rai, you were saying something. Such wonderful work. All of us had a bit more time to interact with you and try and understand your initiatives, but we will have more opportunities to interact as we move on. Thank you very much for joining us, and congratulations to you and the entire team.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I now invite Dr. Ajit Kumar Mishra, Collector and District Magistrate from Nabrangpur, a blue revolution. Mr. Ravindra Kumar, District Magistrate, Unnao, response to COVID. Mr. D.D. Pant, Chief Development Officer from Bageshwar, generation of sustainable livelihood through off-season vegetable cultivation in Ghiroli village.
Good morning, Dr. Anjal.
First of all, let me thank Scotch Group for recognizing our project. In this project, we started the horticulture mechanization, and also we used the hybrid vegetable seeds. This led to the increase in the production of the oxygen vegetables. Earlier it was 400 to 500 quintals. Now we are producing 3,000 to 3,500 quintals of vegetable. And we have increased the income of the farmers from 15,000 to 60,000. Some of the farmers are earning even more than 1 lakh rupees. So with this help of project, we are able to increase the income of the farmers. And I thank the Scotch Group for recognizing our project. Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Mr. Gandham Chandrudu, collector and district magistrate from Anantapuramu, MGNREGA and Integrated Water Management Program.
Hello.
Yes, we can hear you.
Sir, are you?
Looks like there is some connectivity issue. So we move on to the next. I invite Mr. Parvez A. Siddiqui, Secretary, Food and Supplies Department, Government of West Bengal, Khadya Sathi Special Food Coupon System. Dr. Rajat Kumar Panigrahi, Principal, Industrial Training Institute, Barhampur, for COVID Innovation Center.
Thank you, sir. Thank you again for selecting our COVID Innovation Center. During the time of COVID, ITI Barhampur has developed with the integration of skill development and digitalization. We have developed some machines which was highly essential to the society, particularly the UVC Robo Barrier, which was helpful for the sanitization of the transportation system and the rooms where the isolated patients were staying. We have developed a UVC soil sanitizer, which is unique with the help of Adeno technology, IoT. We have sanitized particularly the shoes of the doctors and the healthcare operators who are working in the COVID hospitals. We have again developed a smart swab collection kiosk with negative pressure technology, where is the possibility of leakage of aerosols was zero. By using HEPA filters, we have sanitized it. All these products have got filed for the patents and published in the patent journal also. Honorable Prime Minister has tweeted and shared his photo with our products in the Atmanirbhar Bharat on his Man Ki Baat concept. So we are really feeling grateful to the Scotch team for selecting such a beautiful projects developed by our students and which is at the time of need to the country. Thank you again very much, sir.
Congratulations. Mr. H. S. Mohan, Chief Executive Officer, Infrastructure Equipment Skill Council, train mechanics and operators for high value infrastructure equipments. Mr. Mohan. Mr. Mohan, would you like to say a few words? Am I audible to you? Can you hear us?
No, this is Ramesh Venkat from Logistics Sector Skill Council.
Well, congratulations to you. Captain Ramanujam, Chief Executive Officer from Logistics Sector Skill Council. I believe You are the gentleman with us.
Yeah, thank you so much. It's been an honor and privilege to be a part of this Scotch Order of Merit Award. We represent Logistics Sector Skill Council, and we are into skilling of the youth in logistics and e-commerce, which has been on a great spike and surge post-pandemic. National Skill Development Council projects 28 million youth to be skilled by 2022-23. And it's been an arduous journey and arduous task, right from advocacy to implementation. We are here to advocate and promote apprenticeships among youth in the service sector, like retail, banking, in logistics. Like in manufacturing today, apprenticeships is agnostic across service sectors as well. So today, LSE skills and educates the youth in logistics through schools, colleges, diploma programs, post-graduation programs, thus formalizing the informal sector, organizing the unorganized sector. With better roads and infrastructure, it's been leading us into skilling into the hinterlands. And today, we are glad to emphasize that 22% of our skilling, the youth, is all women. Thanks for giving the opportunity. Look forward. Thank you.
Congratulations. Mr. Anil Kumar Pokhriyal, Chief Executive Officer from Management and Entrepreneurship and Professional Skills Council, online hybrid model of capacity building program for the educators.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Dhanjal and the team Scotch, for again recognizing the efforts of Management, Entrepreneurship and Professional Skills Council. We are very fortunate to have been awarded this Order of Merit Award for the second time. Last time we even got the Silver Award also. We really are thankful, and it gives us a lot of encouragement to continue with our work for the skill development mission in the country in our fields of management and security. In this program, during the COVID, we continued with our enthusiasm and our services to the skilling in the country, where we developed the hybrid model of capacity building program for the educators. And there was no gap in the training. And we worked out the models wherein we really reached out to the beneficiaries and the candidates across the country without any break by leveraging technology in a big way. Thank you again for the jury for again honoring us and encouraging us to continue on the same path of development in the country. Thank you all.
Congratulations once again.
Thank you.
Mr. Lav Agarwal, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and CDAC Mohali, for Project E-Sanjeevani, National Telemedicine Service. Dr. Raman Swathi Vaman, District Program Officer, National Health Mission Kasargod, for Pattam, which is kite, soaring high. Dr. A. Shibulal, District Program Manager, National Health Mission, Mallapuram, for digitization of ASHA program. Dr. Shibulal, once again, District Program Manager from Mallapuram for Kerala Model Transformation of Urban Primary Health Centers in Mallapuram. Mr. Nitin Vishnu Chaudhary, Scientist D and District Informatics Officer from Akola, proposed architecture of cloud computing in Indian government.
Hello, am I audible, sir?
Yes, please, go ahead.
So thank you, Scotch Group, for selecting our work for the award. Basically, this work is a proposed architecture for cloud computing, particularly in the sense that the emerging technologies like Wi-Fi 6, IoT, 5G, this technology produces a very high amount of data at the end user level, as well as it requires the agile real-time processing of the data where the data is produced at the end level. But what happens in terms of cloud? the data centers are located with the centralized processing thousands of miles away from the edge level where the data is actually produced. And this distance of thousands of kilometers produce a latency for the real-time processing. So we have analyzed the cloud architecture and proposed the some emerging technologies that need to be adopted for the agile and real-time processing at the end user level using the cloud. So the cloud should be effective at the end user level also. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chaudhary, for joining us and acknowledging. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Ajay Singh Chahal, Deputy Director General and State Informatic Officer from Himachal Pradesh, COVID-19 Sample Collection Management System.
Good morning, sir. And thank you very much for recognizing our initiative. This is basically the de facto standard for all RT-PCR and rapid antigen tests being conducted and samples being collected in the country. More than 11 crore samples have been collected and sent to ICMR labs. These are 7,000 in number, more than 7,000. And more than 7 lakh sample collectors are using it. The initiative is implemented in 31 states and helps to provide a good data set for Government of India for various purposes. Thank you, sir.
Congratulations. Wonderful work. Mr. Anil Jain, Chief Executive Officer, National Internet Exchange of India for creating digital economy of India.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
This is Suprati Gulia on behalf of our CEO, Sri Anil Kumar Jain. I would love to thank Scotch for the Order of Merit Award. And I'd like to tell everyone about National Internet Exchange of India and the way we are helping in creating the digital economy of India through our three verticals, them being the first Internet Exchange of India, being National Internet Exchange of India. And we are also the registry of .in domains in India. And recently we have achieved a milestone of 2.5 million .in domains being registered. And then we are the owner of IRIN, that is IP resources in India. And on that note, I'd like to thank Scotch for the Order of Merit. And I hope we win the award also today by the end of the day. Thank you so much.
Congratulations and wish you the best. Yeah. Ms. Rukmani Kumari, City Mission Manager from National Urban Livelihoods Mission. Skill training, social mobilization, and self-employment for urban poor. Mr. Satish Chandra Soma, Executive Engineer, Public Health and Municipal Engineering Department, Anantapuram, Hindupur Water Supply Improvements Scheme. Mr. Gandham Chandrudu, Collector and District Magistrate, Rural Water Supply and Sanitation, Anantapur, for Rural Water Supply and Sanitation. You're on mute. We will come back to you and have another opportunity to interact with you. Looks like you are facing some problem. You're not able to unmute yourself. We move on to the next announcement. And I invite Mr. Praveen Yadav, Chief Administrative Officer, MDI India, Health Insurance, TPA Private Limited, for Mukhyamantri Amrutam Yojana. Mr. D.D. Pant, Chief Development Officer, Veterinary Department, Bageshwar, for enhancement of livelihood through increased milk production.
Thank you. Good morning. When we think to increase in milk production, we have to go for two lines. Number one, we have to increase the number of female animals. And number two, we have to go for the breed improvement. There is one more method of artificial insemination where we can increase the milk production. But the drawback with this artificial insemination is that the ratio of female and male progenitors is 50-50. With this our project of sex sorted semen, now we are able to have about 86% of progenies, female progenies. Only 14% progeny are males. Thus, this is a very good project to increase the milk production. Not only this, we are also able to deal with the problem of stray animals with this project. And this is all about our project. Thank you once again.
Congratulations. Once again, Mr. Gandham Chandrudu, Collector and District Magistrate from Anantapuramu, Minor Irrigation. Mr. Gandham, once again, from Anantapur, Handri Neva Sujala Saravanti Project.
Hello. Sir, this is, thank you for inviting us for this Scotch Award function. Sir, is it audible, sir?
Yes.
Sir, our HLS project is a major lift irrigation project, sir. This is mainly intended to supply water to irrigation and drinking water purpose of the drought-prone districts of Rayalaseema region, Kurnool, Anantapur, Kadapa, and Chittoor districts, sir. Particularly, Anantapur is the lowest rainfall district in the second lowest rainfall district in the country itself, sir. So we are able to supply 40 TMC of water from the foreshore of Srisailam project. We are able to supply it for drinking purpose and irrigation purpose of the Rayalaseema. Thank you for the Scotch team once again.
Congratulations. Sir Rajshekhar Nayakanti, Superintending and Engineer from Anantapuramu, Tungabhadra Project High Level Canal. Mr. D.D. Pant, Chief Development Officer from District Bageshwar, Comprehensive Efforts to Improve Sex Ratio at Births, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao.
Thank you, Scott Group, for recognizing our project. The increasing trend of sex ratio at birth in District Bageshwar is going on from 2015-16. In that year, it was only 894, which was much below the national average. Now this sex ratio has gone up to 1012, which is highest in Uttarakhand and at sixth position in national level. Thus, with the help of this project, we are able to increase the sex ratio at birth in Bageshwar. And not only this, we are able to deal with the problem of the discrimination with girls. This is all about our project. And once again, Sadhguru for organizing our project. Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Mr. Ritesh Tandon, Chief Development Project Officer from GIDAM, Integrated Child Development Services.
सभी को जय हिंद सर, धन्यवाद इस स्कॉच ग्रुप को और सभी सिलेक्शन पैनल को भी धन्यवाद. हमने सर दंतेवाड़ा जैसे दूरस्थ अति नक्सल अभी जिले जहां नेटवर्क कनेक्टिविटी पहुंचविहीन जिले में रियल टाइम मॉनिटरिंग की शुरुआत की है सर, जो कि कोविड 19 में हमारे लिए हमारे सर्विस के लिए बहुत ही फ्रूटफुल रहा है. सर दंतेवाड़ा जैसे अति संवेदनशील जिले में कार्य करना बहुत ही चैलेंजिंग रहता है. वहाँ हमने सर रियल टाइम मॉनिटरिंग का इम्प्लीमेंट करने में प्रयास किए हैं सर, और स्कॉच ग्रुप को पुनः धन्यवाद.
Congratulations to you. So that brings us to the end of the announcement of this round of Scotch Order of Merit. You will have the online voting coming up on your screens.